Hi guys, Mark here. Today I will show you how to add snowflakes effect in Lightroom and how to save it as a preset. We will edit few pictures and at the end of that video you will be able to download all presets from my webpage. We can start right now. Okay guys, so to add snowflakes to our pictures, first of all we need to define the brush. So to do that, I'm clicking on masking and I'm trying to set up right values. For me very well works if I'm giving exposure 1.5 or something like that, contrast bit less, highlights bit up, shadows significantly up, clarity significantly down, and sharpness, let's say, bit down. Okay, so if we have something defined, we can save it. So I'm clicking here and save current settings as new preset, and let's call it snowflake one. Okay, cool. So clicking add brush and let's start with something like 0.05. So I'm clicking, as you can see, and adding snowflakes. Okay, you could see my setup here. Size was 5 and the density was 60. I didn't want to have full coverage. Okay, so we added one layer of snow, but to let it look natural, we need to have different sizes of the snow. So I'm clicking again brush and we'll add another layer. Let's say 4 this time. Okay, need to switch to snowflake. We defined earlier and you can see let's give a moment for Lightroom, and everywhere when we clicked, we have right now the snowflakes. We can experiment and we can make it more white or less white. You can choose what works the best for you and for the particular picture, but let's go further. Okay, so we have 2 layers, we need to add a bit more. So let's try with something quite big. Okay, and again, not custom, but snowflake. Okay, I think looks good. Okay, adding another layer. Something smaller, like 3 right now. In the red points, you can see what I'm adding, but I would like to choose the preset defined earlier by us. So I'm choosing snowflake and everywhere it is marked snowflake. Right now, maybe we have enough, but I will do one more step. And right now I will add something more, even more small, even smaller, like 2. As you can see I will remove it later. But you can see for that picture, the best visible is on the water. Okay, I'm changing it again. I'm trying to change it again to snowflake. And as I made mistake here, so I'm clicking erase and removing it. Okay, cool. Okay guys, so what we have done. So first of all, we created our brush snowflake 1 with such values. After that, we used that snowflake brush to create the 5 different layers of snowflakes. Every layer was with different size of snowflakes and sometimes with different brightness. We did it because we wanted our picture looks more natural. But for the next pictures, we don't want to start everything from scratch. So to avoid that problem, we can create the preset right now. So to create the preset, we need to go here, click presets and create preset. So let's call it Snowflake 1. And I will create new group, mark that's Snow 1. Okay, I'm checking only mask from 3 to 7 because first and second mask was not relevant to the snowflakes and I'm interested only in snowflakes. Okay, so create, done. Okay, so let's check if our preset works also for different pictures. So I'm choosing snowflake preset and this is with and without. Okay, so I think it works quite well for that picture. Okay, so let's try our preset on totally different picture. I mean on landscape. So if I click it, it's added. Snow has been added. It's maybe okay, but per my view, there is too much snow in the bottom, too less on the top. And probably I would prefer to have much smaller snowflakes on the top as this is landscape. So I'm not applying that one. I will do that bit differently. So again, I'm creating new mask, of course, and I'm using brush, but this time it will be just one. So very small. And what I'm doing, of course, I'm choosing our snowflake. Okay. And let's try to add a lot of small snowflakes on the sky and generally on the picture. Okay, and I'm not adding another layers. I will save it as a preset, but need wait a moment because Lightroom is still working on it. Okay, so done. So click here, create preset, snowflake 2, only mask 3. Okay, create. So I have it as a separate preset. Now we can add again the snowflake 1. And right now we have both presets joined together. I mean, we have snowflakes from the first one and from the second one. Of course, if we would like, we can remove particular layers if we like, or we can remove particular elements as well. So here I would like to remove those few snowflakes. And of course, I can do that quite easily. Clicking on mask, erase. Okay, and per my view, this is better. So this is done. We can compare with version without changes. So this is without snowflakes, and on the right side, this is with snowflakes. So you can see the difference. Per my view, effect is quite good. Okay, so let's try on something different. I mean, this time this is night landscape. So I'm trying to use our flake 1. Okay, something is visible and I'm trying to add also snowflake 2. Okay, almost not visible. So how we can fix it? Quite easily. Let's focus on the last layer and let's change exposure so you can see snowflakes are getting visible right now. And what we need to do, I think we need to do for every layer. Let's do that quickly. Okay. This only slightly. Okay. And okay. So we can see this is before without snowflakes, and this is with our snowflakes. So I think it looks not bad. But per my view, we could add more. I'm not going to add it right now. I prepared it offline. Okay, this one, I think it looks a bit more interesting. Of course, we can again combine it with our new presets. So we can add even more. Everything else is up to us. I will save that preset also, so you will be able to download all three presets from my page. But guys, this was my very first editing. If you are interested how I came from this one till this one, and I'm not talking about snowflakes, I'm talking about this color grading or color correction, please let me know in the comments. I'm very happy to create a video about that to show you how you can do such changes. I hope that video was useful for you. In the description you will find a link to download all presets. I really appreciate if you click like button and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like that in the future. Thank you very much, guys.